guess I'm going to walk. Oh, that milky white wing. Oh, child, some of these days. Well, I'm going to walk that milky white wing. Oh, some of these days. Well, 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 I'm going to walk up and take up my stand. Gonna join that Christian band. I'm going to walk, whoa, that milky white wing. Oh, Lord, some of these days.
Tell who shall gather them. children, Grandpa. It's even ending. Deliver me from all my fears. And make me not a regret unto the fools.
Sacred scene in the light of life.
we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost. Ever shall be, world without end. Now it's Christ risen from the dead and become the first. Thank you. Amen. Let everybody say amen. It's good to be here. It could have been the other way. I've always say that bad can be worse and good can be better. We are here to celebrate the homegoing of Deacon Edgar Jr. I believe his celebration means to be alive. And first of all, we'd like to give honor to all the clergymen and to the waiting family. They have prepared a program for us, and we are going to go according to the program. I found out one thing, that if I can't do like I want to do, I do like I can. And one thing for sure, our mouth is not bound up. What that means, I can tell God thank you. If you have brought me and all of us for a mighty and a mighty long ways. So we have the program, the prayer about Reverend Call.
Let us pray. Eternal God, our Father, come at this hour with bowed heads and on my heart. We come, my Father, because you said come. You said that when we needed you, said call your name. And Lord, we need you every day of our lives. We need you in our home, in our church house. We need you all day long. But it just seems like, Lord, in times like these, that it's when we need you the most. So we ask now, Father, that you would touch, that you would bless in a mighty and special way. Oh, eternal God, let them know that you have the power in your hand. Let them know, our Father, that we've been come in the morning. So we ask now, Lord, that you would touch them and let them continue to keep them for come from you. And we beg you now, Father, that I will hold them in the hollow of your hand. Oh, Father, bless them now. Dry tears from their eyes, bind up their broken heart. And let them know, eternal God, that you still live. And then, eternal God, we know that one day, sooner or later, we all got to step off of the circumspective of time, and we got to move to eternity. And when that time comes, we ask, Lord, that you will accept all of us into your kingdom, for this is your servant prayer. Amen, and thank you, Jesus.
From a scripture, the Old Testament, Reverend James Jackson, and the New, Reverend Lorraine Brenda Ray. Just a portion of St. John, chapter 14, and verse 1. It said, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it was not so, I would have told you.
I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And whether I go, ye know. And the way, you know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know not whither thou goest. How can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. And the Lord had a blessing to the reading of his word. We'll proceed with it.
They will be cut from. In everything, there is a season, a time to curse, a time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, a time to pluck up that which is planted, a time to kill, a time to heal, a time to break down, and a time to build up, a time to weep, a time to laugh, a time to moan, and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones, a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace, a time to refrain from embracing, a time to get, a time to loose, a time to keep, and a time to cast away, a time to run, and a time to sow, a time to keep silent, and a time to speak, a time to love, a time to hate, a time of walk, and a time of peace. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of this word. Thank you.
Amen. We have a solo by Deacon James Lester.
Good morning, good morning. How's everybody feeling? How's everybody feeling? Y'all know the funeral is over with. It's time to celebrate now. Huh? Talk to me. If he was still alive, would you be like this? Huh? Talk to me. We getting ready to praise God for what he has done. It wasn't us, it was him. And what did the Bible say? When praises go up, what come down? Do we want a blessing? Even though God know our condition right now, he know what we going through, but it's time to praise him, amen? Y'all come on and help me sing this little song, Read God's Letter. I know you done heard about it. I know you know it, but we gonna praise God today, amen? Amen, amen. You ought to read God's letter all night. You ought to read God's letter. You ought to read God's letter. Yeah. Well, I heard the voice of Jesus saying, come unto me and rest. Lay down thy weary. One lay down and I head up on my. You ought to read God's letter. You ought to read God's letter. You ought to read God's letter. You lamb that saved a wretch like me. I was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but now you are the reconciler. You are the reconciler. Come on, come on. You are the reconciler. Listen. Is he worthy? I know we all love Edgar Jr., but God love him best. And we have to accept what he have done. And we have to accept the life that he lived. He lived a beautiful, happy life. If he wasn't happy, you can't tell it. Because he was a good man. He have you smiling all the time. He was a good man. If something were wrong with him, you would never know it. That was my brother. And I love him to this day. I'm gonna miss him. But I know God gonna take care of him. Better than any of us can. Do you feel good about it? Do you feel good about it? Glory, hallelujah. Thank you.
Amen. We have reflection by Mr. Andrew Smith Jr.
As I stand to celebrate Granddad, nobody should be sad. He has some good memories, lad. Granddad was a comedian. I'm gonna tell you a couple stories. I never forget when I was young, little bitty boy, out of this church right here. Granddad said, "Hey boy, come on up here and help me lead the devotion." I said, "All right." So I went up there, I said, "Man, a lot of people looking at me." So he led the devotion, he reached over there to me. He said, "Hey boy, you wanna pray?" I said, Granddad, I wanna pray. So we got through, came out the door, he said, "Boy, let me ask you something, you know the Lord's Prayer?" I said, "Yes, I know the Lord's Prayer." He said, "All you had to do, say the Lord's Prayer and miss and seal with it." I said, "But Granddad, let me ask you something." I say, "Once I got through the Lord's Prayer, they have still been singing." He said, "Well, let them sing." He said, "Eventually they'll stop." And the year passed, everybody loved to go to Granddad's house. Christmas, Thanksgiving, Easter, go. But I'm going to pick on you for 1 second, Grandma. I never forget. We were there, and somebody called Granddad. Said, I got a story for y'all to tell about Granny. He said, yes. Somebody called. Say some of her folks done got into it down the road. He said, yeah. Say, they don't know me. I go down there and I light it up. He said she went on down there. And say he heard ambulance coming, police coming. Say somebody came back up there. Say Mr. Edgar Lester. Say, your wife Bernie, she done fell out down there. Granddad looked at him. He said, well, she said she was gonna go down there and light it up. But even though a limb had fell from the family tree, and it saved. And I think of me in my best time. Grieve for me not, because when I was young and strong, so y'all think about it, he did a joke, he did a good thing. And as I take my seat, the last joke I heard him tell me, I ain't gonna say how he said it, but I'm gonna say it. He said, water boy, pass it around. If you ain't got no water, sit down. So if you go sit down.
Amen. It's good to have a laugh. Solo Sister Deborah.
Soon I will be done with the trouble of this world, the trouble of this world, the trouble of this world. Soon I will be done with the trouble of this world. I'm going home to live with the Lord. Soon I will be done with the trouble of this world, the trouble of this world, the trouble of this world. Ooh, soon I will be done with the trouble of this world. I'm going home. No more weeping, no more weeping, oh Lord, no more weeping, no more weeping, ooh, no more. See my Jesus, 'cause I'm going home. this world. Hallelujah. The troubles are this world. Ooh, soon it will be done with the trouble of this world. I'm going home, going home to live with the Lord. Hallelujah.
Somebody need to say hallelujah. God good all the time. God is good. Amen. Soon it's going to be all over. But right now, we have a chance to tell God thank you. We cannot be trying to look cute today. Say amen. God have blessed us. There are many things happening all over the world. But then God spared our life. And we got something to give God the praises for. I mean, we got to do like we do at home. And what I mean by that is we so loud, we stir up the whole neighborhood. And then we get to church and we can't hardly hear or say nothing. But amen means so it is. Say amen. Glory to God. It's just good to be here. Good to be here. Good to be alive. Now, I'm not a dead preacher now. I refuse to be quiet. I know God is able to carry us through. God is able just to carry. Make no difference what the world may do. I keep on trusting in my Jesus. And everything you do, God is able just to carry you through. God is able, come on wife, just to carry you. Sing. Make no difference what the world may do. I keep on trusting in my Jesus. Everything you do, God is just to carry. Well, it ain't no secret what God can do. What he done for others, he'll do the same for you. But I keep on trusting in me. Everything you do, God is just to carry. If you can, wave your hand and say he's able. Carrying you through, make no difference what the world may do. Yeah, I keep on trusting in my dreams. Everything God is able. Woke me up this morning, God. Started me on my way, y'all. Every now and then, I think about he blessing me right now. He woke me up this morning. Still had the activity of my limb. I know he's able. Yeah. I know he's able. God is able. You know, I'm glad it's an individual thing. but nobody can feel it for you. You only can feel it for your own self. You cannot depend on nobody else, but you got to work out your own soul salvation in the fear of God and trembling. We thank God, amen, that he allowed us to sing one more time. He have blessed Deacon Lester with long life. Some of you young today, but you don't know whether you'll be here tomorrow or not. So we need to look to the hill today, for which cometh out of him. And God knows I didn't come to try to make nobody shout, but I came to let you think about something, that you got to do what he has already done. You didn't come in this world to stay. And I know that many good things had been said about him. But guess what? He can't hear none of it. Whatever you got to say, say it now. Don't wait until somebody gone on home, because they're too far to hear you. They can't hear you. Say it now. Tell me I'm ugly now. Don't wait until I'm gone. But tell me now. Amen. I did plenty of revivals down this way. Amen. And I feel lifted up today. Guess what? That's my cousin too. In case some of you don't know, that's my cousin. And I feel like if somebody were joyful in their lifetime, when they leave, they don't want nobody feeling sad over them. And the news that I've gotten from him, that he was full of joy, and he would make you laugh if your heart wasn't too hard. But out of all of that, he still had to leave. And I know that I can't do like I feel like doing. I'm just gonna do what the Lord lead me to do. Amen. Some of you don't know me. I'm Brother Lundy. And I'm going in a word here. Maybe it can shine some light on somebody's life. Because what he has done, that's not going to help you. You're going to have to do it for yourself. Looking in the book of Hebrews, and I believe chapter 9 and verse 27, it read, as it is appointed unto men once to die, but after this the judgment. So Christ was once offered to bear the sins of many, and unto them that look for him shall he appear the second time without sin unto salvation. Just a few words today. It's not over yet. It's not over yet. It goes farther than the grave. If it went just to the grave, all of us would be in pretty good shape. But it's not over at the grave. After death, you got something else to do. It's not over there. You can have the best insurance in the world, and it will only get you into the cemetery. But to get into the kingdom, you're going to need something else. Thank you, Jesus. God has put this that we may take notice. We got to leave here some way or another. Some way or another, you've got to get off of here. This mortal is going to have to put on immortality. This old terrestrial body going to have to take on celestial. Flesh and blood can't get into heaven. And if I want somebody to tell a lie today, I can ask them, is he saved? You have hand waving everywhere. But God knows the hearts of every man. Man cannot judge whether you are right or wrong. God going to do that. He told the preacher, the pastors in the church, let the wheat and the tare grow together. I separate them. Why are you trying to straighten out one somebody? You pull up somebody else. But it's not over there at the grave. After death, he said to judge me. And the good part about it, if I've been born again, and I'm going to say it today, if I've been born again, I don't have to even worry about the white throne judgment. My sins are judged when God forgives me. Thank you, Jesus. When he forgave me for my sin was there. He's casting into the sea of forgetfulness to be remembered no more. Now, some of you may remember what somebody else have done, but your remembrance doesn't mean what he is. God judges our heart. He does not judge what you do when he judges your heart. There are many people can do the same thing and God judge them different. Because you did it because you wanted to do it. Somebody else did it because they were too weak. They couldn't help but to do it. Thank you, Jesus. It ain't over there. John had been put up on that Isle of Patmos. Thank you, Jesus. They put him out there for the wild beast to eat him up. All the rest of them had gone on in. Nero chopping block was on Paul. Thank you, Jesus. But John had gotten an old man. I don't know whether his head was gray or not. But he had gotten to be an old man, and they put him out there on the Isle of Patmos. But while he was out there on the Isle of Patmos, the Bible say he was in the spirit. Not just in the church, he was in the spirit. On the Lord day. Thank you, Jesus. We be in the church on the Lord day. But he was in the spirit on the Lord day, and God began to talk to him. John said, I saw. Glory to God. He said, I saw a throne. And him that sat up on the throne, whose face does fled away. Thank you, Jesus. And he said, the books was open. I saw a crowd, great and small, standing there. And he said, the books with S on it, I've been to school one day, but with S on it, mean more than one book. He said, the books was open, and the dead, glory to God. Now, you realize that I'm not the dead. I'm alive. The dead were them folk that you couldn't tell nothing. Were them people that didn't come out from under Adam's sin. People that didn't believe what the preacher said when he preached. The dead were judged. I told you they ain't over at the cemetery. The dead were judged out of the things that were written in the books with the S on. Glory to God. Then he said another book was open, which was the book of life. Now, it didn't take but one book in the whole lot of Christians. But it took books in the whole them devils. Y'all don't hear me. It took more than one book. Why? Because all the deeds and the things that they had ever done were written in that book. But look at the book of life. Wasn't nothing in there but names. Lord, have mercy, Jesus. Just names. That was the record book. And the Bible say, he that was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire that burneth with fire and brimstone. Thank you, Jesus. Then he backed up just a little bit. I got to get out of the way. Backed up just a little bit and said, blessed and holy is he that has part in the first resurrection. See, at the first resurrection, the dead in Christ going to get up. And those that yet remain around here, they're going to be changed within the twinkling of an eye, caught up to meet the Lord in the air. Glory to God. What? I'm going to meet those saints, old patriarchs, those of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. When Jesus rose from the grave, he carried all of those people up to the second heaven. Lord Jesus, the second heaven, which is the paradise for all the Christian folk that die. Glory to God. And if you end up dying here, you know you're going to hell. Thank you, Jesus. Even the thief on the cross was caught up with all of those. When Jesus came out the grave, he hadn't been down there. Why? Why? Because the devil had Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, all of them were chained into prison. But then when Jesus went down there, I ain't gonna have time to finish this. When Jesus went down there, they put him in the tomb. Glory to God. But when they went out there to check on him, they didn't find nothing but his clothes there. What happened to Jesus? The Bible said he went down in hell and preached to the spirits that were there. Glory to God. He went there and unlocked the prison cell while Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and Daniel, Isaiah, all those old prophets could come out. But listen what he said. He said, y'all can't come out yet. I got to get out of him first. I'm the first fruit of the dead. So y'all got to wait on me. So when Jesus got up on the ground, he looked back at the grave and said, oh grave, where's your victory? Oh death, where's your sting? Glory to God. Then after he done got up, then he told them, now y'all can come. The grave was open and they came up. The Bible said they walked the streets of Jerusalem 42 days. And Jesus told them, you can't touch me now. Y'all heard that you can't touch this. Glory to God. He said, I hadn't been back to my Father to be glorified. Y'all can't touch me. Thank you, Jesus. But what we going to do, I'm going to take you back with me. I'm going to ascend back up to my Father. But if y'all can't go up to where he's at, I'm going to drop you off in the second heaven, which is the paradise. And the thief that said, remember me when you enter into your Father's kingdom, he was right there with them. Took them on up there, dropped them off. Then Jesus went on up then and sat down on the right hand of God. But that's where he's at now, making intercession for us. Right now. Thank you, Jesus. But one day, he's coming back. The Bible tell you, he's coming back. He's coming back. And every eye gonna see him. Every tongue gonna have to confess that Jesus is Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Y'all excuse me for not preaching to him because I can't preach to the dead. The dead can't hear, but you can. Yeah. Go home and tell somebody it's not over yet. You may be popping your fingers now. You may be shaking your hips now, but it's not over yet. And death doesn't have an age. Your name is on that rule book somewhere, and you don't know when it's coming up. You don't know who next, but you just be ready when Jesus comes. God bless you now. Thank you.
Let the church say amen. Can we say it again? Come on and give God praise, for this is a life lived by the grace of God. Longevity. I am delighted to have this opportunity to be here to the pastor and other officials, most of all to this bereaved family. I stand coming from Atlanta, ran into an accident on the way and delayed beyond circumstances, but I told Sister Lassiter that I would be here, and so I'm here by the grace of God, remembering the life and the legacy of Deacon Lassiter. We called him Mr. Edgar. Amen. Growing up in the neighborhood, amen, in Cordell, right across the street from his wife, and I knew Mr. Edgar, amen, as the furniture store man. He delivered plenty of furniture all over Cordell, and he had a warm spirit. He was sincere, but he had a way of making you laugh. Amen. I knew him many times to come by the house cutting my daddy's hair. He'd show up. I'd be on the outside. He said, "Boy, where your dad at? Tell him I said, come on out of that house. He got to stop eating sometime." Amen. But I stand to say to Sister Lassiter and the rest of the family, I grew up with his children as well. Amen. I say to you that God made a promise that he would not leave us comfortless. And you have no reason to hang your head down but to look up, because God said that he was going away to prepare a place for us. And one day he'd come again and receive us unto himself. And I believe Deacon Lassiter was ready, had his mind made up and determined to meet the Master. So I say to the family, our challenge is to be ready when our day comes. Because as the pastor have already said, it's appointed unto man once to die, and after that, the judgment. God bless you. Be encouraged. Certainly, you have our prayer.
Death is God's promise, Lord. So family, trust in him. Doubt him never. Remember that it's only through dying that Mr. Edgar can and will live forever. The family of Deacon Edgar Lassiter Jr. wishes to express their most sincere and heartfelt appreciation to Pastor Lundy, other program participants, and each of you who have been so kind to them. They thank you for the many gestures of love and sympathy that have been extended to them. They thank you for the many words of encouragement. But most of all, they thank you for the prayers that have been prayed for them. They ask that you will continue to pray for them, not just today, but pray for them on tomorrow and all the tomorrows to come. That they may grow stronger and know that we serve a God who is able, one who can do anything but fail. At this time, we wish to acknowledge floral offering that have been sent for the family. With deepest sympathy, the Larry Barnes family. Sincere condolences, remembering each of you in our prayers. Pastor Darrell and First Lady Leggett, and the Cordial Institutional Church of God in Christ. With deepest sympathy, the Christianity High School class of 1971. With deepest sympathy, Deacon Bobby James and family. With deepest sympathy, John and Early Lester and family. With deepest sympathy, Macedonia Baptist Church family. In loving memory of Deacon Edgar Lester Jr., your baby sister, Allie Lester, I will always love you, and I will always remember you as a wonderful person. With deepest sympathy, your brother, Oscar, Joshua, Damisha, Naomi, Joy Lee, Shatiris, Oscar, and Deshaun. With deepest sympathy, the Free Providence Baptist Church, Reverend Choice Cobb, pastor, your Norborn family, from your McDonald's family. With deepest sympathy, the Pleasant Valley Baptist Church, Dr. Beverly M. Bolton, pastor. The family flowers given in loving memory, loving and caring husband, father, grandfather, great-grandfather, brother, uncle, and friend from the family. In loving memory of Dr. Napoleon Williams, Deacon Arthur L. Parker, CEO and president, along with the staff of the J.W. Williams Funeral Home, presents to this family an African-American family heirloom Bible. It is our prayer that as you journey through this season of grief, that you know that you're not alone, that God's love is with you, and no matter what you're experiencing, that the answer can be found in the Word of God. Look to Him for your strength and your comfort. We're also pleased to present to this family a picture and tribute of Mr. Edgar's life. Just saying his name makes you smile. And as you remember him and think about all the many memories, remember that smile and the things that he made you laugh about. For we know that anyone who has ever loved is never lost. And because he was loved so much, he will forever live on in each of us who have the opportunity to know him. It is our prayer that you're blessed now and always.
Again, to tell you thank you. Legacy, Dick Lobster, you continue to bless this family, continue to hold them in the hollow of your hand. Show them for long traveling, Lord, and we'll continue to live on and praise your name. Oh, bless night, tell them God on a mighty and special way. And Lord, when we'll come to the close of the day, we ask that you accept us into your kingdom. This is your servant prayer. Amen.
Much as it has pleased the Almighty God in His wise providence, take out of this world the soul of our deceased brother. We therefore commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, looking for the general resurrection, the life of the world to come, through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Let's see. Earth and the sea shall give up that dead. The corruptible bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed and made likened unto his glorious body, whereby he is able to subdue all things unto to himself. Blessed are the dead that dies in the Lord. Said the spirit, henceforth shall they rest from all of their labor. In Jesus' name. Now may the grace of God, the sweet communion of the Holy Ghost, rest, rule, and abide with these people henceforth, now and forevermore. In Jesus' name, amen.